Solve 2 sine squared x equals 1 over the interval from 0 to 2 pi, closed on 0, open on 2 pi. Beginning with the given equation, we first isolate sine squared x by dividing both sides by 2. Simplifying, we have sine squared x equals 1/2. Next, we want to undo the squaring by square rooting both sides of the equation. But remember, we can square a positive and a negative to get a positive. And therefore, when we square root both sides of the equation, we need to include a plus or minus on the right so that we get all solutions. Simplifying, we now have sine x equals plus or minus the square root of 1/2, which is equal to plus or minus the square root of 1 divided by the square root of 2, which gives us sine x equals plus or minus the square root of 1 is 1, giving us 1 divided by square root 2. We're looking for all the angles that have a sine function value of positive or negative 1 divided by square root 2 over the interval from 0 to 2 pi, including 0 and not including 2 pi. Well, having a sine function value of 1 divided by square root 2 should remind us of a 45 degree angle, or a pi divided by 4 angle. And because we're looking for all the angles over the interval from 0 to 2 pi that have a sine function value of plus or minus 1 divided by square root 2, we need to sketch a pi divided by 4 reference angle in each of the four quadrants. Let's begin by doing this. There's the reference angle in the first quadrant. Here's the reference angle in the second quadrant. Here's the reference angle in the third quadrant. And the reference angle in the fourth quadrant. Remember, the sine function value is positive, where y is positive. Sine is positive in the first and second quadrants, negative in the third and fourth quadrants. And just for the fun of it, let's go ahead and sketch the reference triangles. In the first quadrant, where both x and y are positive, we can label both legs positive 1, the hypotenuse square root 2. In the second quadrant, where x is negative and y is positive, we can label the horizontal leg negative 1, vertical leg positive 1, hypotenuse square root 2. In the third quadrant, both x and y are negative, both legs are negative 1, hypotenuse is square root 2. And finally, in the fourth quadrant, where x is positive and y is negative, we can label the vertical leg negative 1, hypotenuse square root 2. Notice in the first and second quadrants, the sine function values are 1 divided by square root 2. In the third and fourth quadrants, the sine function values are negative 1 divided by square root 2. And now let's determine our four solutions. In quadrant 1, we have pi divided by 4. In the second quadrant, we have 3/4 pi radians, or 3 pi divided by 4 radians. In the third quadrant, we have 4/4 pi plus 1/4 pi, which gives us 5/4 pi radians, or 5 pi divided by 4 radians. And then in the fourth quadrant, again, we have 4/4 pi, 5/4 pi, 6/4 pi, and finally 7/4 pi radians, or 7 pi divided by 4. These are the four solutions to the given equation over the interval from 0 to 2 pi, closed on 0, open on 2 pi. Before we go, let's also verify these values on the unit circle. To do this, though, we do want to rationalize 1 divided by square root 2 by multiplying the numerator and denominator by the square root of 2. Notice this gives us the sine function values of plus or minus square root 2 divided by 2. Remember, on the unit circle, sine theta equals y. Notice in quadrants 1 and 2, we have angles that have a sine function value of positive square root 2 divided by 2. Those angles are pi divided by 4 and 3 pi divided by 4. And then in the third and fourth quadrants, we have angles that have a sine function value of negative square root 2 divided by 2, which are 5 pi divided by 4 and 7 pi divided by 4. I hope you found this helpful.